lot of programs out there, but nothing that was really Christ-centered, that the churches are equipped for, or, you know, when you get out of the gospel, we need that mentorship, that brotherhood, and that sisterhood. And that's why I celebrate recovery. And coming here is a bond that you build with people, with Christ-like understanding, and working together to someone to listen instead of just trying to fix me.
First heard about this program was I thought, wow, this would be great for my husband. And if I get involved with it, this will encourage him to come and participate along with me, something we can do together, and there will be some good come for him from it. I had no idea, because God works this way, I had no idea that this was actually what I needed to do.
In John chapter 16, verse 33, it says, I've told you these things so that you will have peace. In this world, you will have trouble, but take heart, I've overcome the world. Whether you're a Christian or you're not a Christian, you're going to have times when there is no peace.
I wanted to find something more suitable for people to work on their habits, their hang-ups, their hurts.
I needed community because living in the world is kind of difficult sometimes, and having community it makes situations lighter. And what keeps me coming is the community and the growth that I get from being encouraged by other people.
Celebrate recovery means overcoming to do.
And I keep coming because God keeps calling me to come. Trying to be obedient to Him and make the changes that I need to make. Because I mean, I knew it wasn't perfect, but I didn't know that I was needing this as much as I was needing it.
Originally, started with Celebrate Recovery just to be part of leadership.
Accepting that and by really realizing it, that's what's made the changes. Is, you know, and the reality though is asking God to change me means I need to be prepared to accept what those changes look like.
I would have to say step four, and that to openly confess my hurt habits or hang ups was, I think, huge pivotal in my recovery. Just to give all that away to God. I think the most important part of it
we'll be right back.
That's devastating. Because I went to a feast on my elders.
I thought, no, and that's the one that stands out the most to me. Because I'm not, I can't fix the situation. I can't fix somebody else that's in the situation. I can't, I don't have control. I've learned to let that control.
Come through the front doors and
see what it's all about.